Hi, I'm Danvers. I'm the Hoof Health Consultant for SmartPak, and I'm going to talk with you about abscesses. Abscess is a profoundly debilitating issue that we see, especially in wet environments with our horses. They'll present with such a lameness that you'll think they have a broken leg at times. It's a very, very painful concern for these horses. They can be life-threatening. They are, in fact, not a routine issue. For those of us who live in wet environments, it seems like they're routine, but they should never be treated as routine. You need to get your veterinarian and your hoof care specialist involved. Let them deal with it. An abscess is basically a localized infection. It's a pocket that has become infected, has walled off. And so you have a walled off infection that's creating pressure in the foot. For it to wall off, it has to gain entry. So most often that's going to be in the white line area of the foot or the lamina. It can be anywhere from the toe all the way around. Remember that the lamina doesn't terminate at the heel. It wraps around and follows the bar. So it can gain access there as well. You'll very often see these in the wall. You'll see them in the bar. You'll also occasionally see abscesses that occur throughout the solar area of the foot. These are much more suspect because that usually means that there was some sort of insult that where a horse has stepped on something and created that point of entry. So it could be that he stepped on a nail, a sharp branch or something. But if you see one in the sole, there's been something that provided an opportunity for it to enter into that area. So you very often have a puncture wound that is associated with one that you find in the sole. So those definitely more suspect. The idea is to get that open and vented so that you release the pressure. If you don't do that, it will tend to track up the wall and finally work its way out and make its own vent at the hairline. If that happens, then you've got 6 months to a year of working with that as it grows down. So the best idea is to get it to vent from the bottom, get it over with quickly and not have a maintenance issue for the next 6 months to a year. It'll also very often track laterally and you'll have a subsolar abscess. So, and those are frustrating because they linger forever. You'll have a horse that will be lame for 3 days, then he'll be sound. Then he'll be lame for 3 days, then he'll be sound. And this can go on for months as that abscess tracks laterally under the sole between the new growth and the old exfoliating sole. So the key to getting this dealt with is to catch it early and get it to vent from the bottom, not to let it cause the horse pain and track up over 3-4 days or even a week before it finally vents on its own. And so you have to be a little bit of a control freak, make it vent from the bottom. And so once that's vented, then you have to make sure that you draw the infection out of it. The traditional approach to this is Epsom salt soaks, warm Epsom salt soaks. Various veterinarians will recommend any number of products to use for drawing agents, but the important thing is to make sure that you do get the infection to draw out of it, to use a drawing salve, a warm soak, whatever. My personal preference, because I live in the great Midwest and I deal with wet feet, I don't like to soak because that's part of what got us into the trouble in the first place. The foot was overly hydrated, it was wet. And so if I stick it in a bucket of water 3 times a day, I'm going to exacerbate the condition. So I like to use a drawing salve are a drawing product. I typically will tape animal lintex into the area and let it draw. That way I don't have to deal with a warm bucket of water and trying to get a horse to put his foot in it and stand quietly for 30 minutes at a time. It's simply easy to use. You tape it in, ignore it, come back, tape it in again.
Research shows that over 60% of performance horses suffer from painful gastric ulcers. Loved by riders and backed by research, SmartGut Ultra provides the ultimate gastric support. Visit smartpak.com/sguresearch to learn more.
Once the infection is drawn out, you still have an issue of the potential for reinfection, because you've created a pocket that is going to pack with something unproductive. It's going to pack with fecal matter, urine, dirt, any manner of ick that's going to get into that and potentially reinfect. So you want to pack it with something that is productive. That can be something as simple as a cotton ball soaked in betadine, or it can be a commercially available product. Once I'm sure that the infection is out, I'll take a hoof packing like I would use under a pad. Make sure that you're packing it with something productive, otherwise it's going to pack with something unproductive. I hope you found that helpful. Remember, abscesses are always an issue of concern. They're never routine. Stay with us here at SmartPak as we work on more hoof care concerns.